Hello, friends and community members. Like all of our events this year, the African Heritage Proclamation launch is going to be a virtual celebration. We are happy to present this video to the community in honor of African Heritage Month. And I encourage all of you to take advantage of the many different virtual African Heritage Month events and lectures taking place across the province. These are great opportunities for us to listen, learn, act, and share the legacy of Black Nova Scotians and the stories that represent this province's history. I would like to thank all of the committee members and partners who have helped to put this video together. I would especially like to acknowledge and thank the long-standing support of the Zone 7 African Cultural Heritage Awareness Association Committee. Thank you and enjoy.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Okay, whereas February is recognized internationally as African Heritage Month, a time to recognize and salute the many contributions and ongoing achievements of people of African descent all over the world, and here in the town and county of Antigonish in the province of Nova Scotia. We are pleased to unite each year to observe the important event, African Heritage Month. And whereas in the seventh year of the International Decade for People of African Descent, it is our aim to both highlight in partnership contributions of the people of African descent to societies locally and throughout the world, strengthening and promoting diversity and inclusion to ensure human rights of people of African descent are respected, protected, and fulfilled. And whereas this year's theme, Black History Matters, Listen, Learn, Act, and Share, recognizes the important legacy of people of African descent and the long-standing history in the development of Canada. This theme brings focus and increased awareness of racialized issues of a community that has overcome great adversity for inclusion in all aspects of society. Therefore, be it resolved that I, Mayor Lori Boucher, do hereby proclaim the month of February to be African Heritage Month. I encourage residents, businesses, and community groups to participate in the celebrations and to take the opportunity to reflect on the story of Nova Scotia's vibrant African Nova Scotian community.
Hello, I'm Reverend Peter Smith from here at St. James United Church in Antigonish. It's my pleasure to offer this opening prayer for our African Heritage celebrations this month. This year, our celebrations will look a little different than they have in years past, as we're not able to have so many in-person events. But it's still an opportunity for us to listen to the stories of African Nova Scotians, African Canadians, and peoples of African descent from around the world. It's still a chance for us to learn of the triumphs and the struggles of those in the past and those who are here in our communities this day. It's still an opportunity for us to share our vision of a better community that could and should be in this world. And it's still an opportunity for us to act, to build that community for us and for those who are coming after us. Let us pray. Most gracious and most wondrous God, open our ears that we might hear the stories of triumph and struggles of African Nova Scotians, African Canadians, and all peoples of African descent. Open our minds that we might learn. Learn of the realities of our world and what is happening here now and the changes that need to happen. Open our hearts that we might share our beliefs and our hopes for a better tomorrow. And open our hands that we might act to build a community where all are cherished, all are treasured, and all are celebrated. For we offer this prayer for ourselves and for each other as we begin our African Heritage Month here in Nova Scotia. Amen. Thank you, and God bless.
Hello, Antigonish. It is my honor and pleasure to join you for the 2021 African Heritage Month Civic Proclamation event. African Heritage Month is a time to celebrate, honor, and recognize the history, culture, and achievements of people of African descent. Our province acknowledges the strength, resiliency, and determination shown by more than 50 African Nova Scotian communities that call this place home. We have remarkable individuals who have created long-lasting legacies and remarkable people who make solid contributions to our province every day. This year's theme, Black History Matters, Listen, Learn, Share, and Act, calls on all of us to make Nova Scotia a better society by recognizing the long-standing history and legacy of African Nova Scotians, as well as acknowledging racialized issues and adversity for people of African descent. It is through the power of understanding, empathy, and open dialogue that we will bring about inclusivity and inspiration, even during the most challenging of times. In 2020, we experienced a year of uncertainty, pain, heartache, and worry. But community members of all ages stepped up to help support the most vulnerable. Helping one another is a quality in the African Nova Scotian community that I am most proud of. And even though some of us are still experiencing difficulties, it is said that the most challenging of times can be an opportunity for positive transformation. We must remain hopeful. The future is bright for all of us. We know our province is stronger because of the accomplishments by African Nova Scotians. Collaboration with government and the African Nova Scotian community has been key to effective transformation. Important progress has been made, but there is certainly more work to be done. I would like to thank each member of the African Nova Scotian community for their contributions you have made, and I know you will continue to make. And thank you to all Nova Scotians for your efforts to get involved in making a positive difference in the lives of African Nova Scotians. Your work is needed to bring about changes to make this a better place. Thank you and enjoy African Heritage Month. Please stay safe.
Hi, my name is Lauren Skinner and I go to Dr. John Hugh Gillis in Antigonish. And today I'm going to be reading a poem called America Will Be by Joshua Bennett. I am now at the age where my father calls me brother when we say goodbye. Take care of yourself, brother. He whispers a half beat before we hang up the phone. And it is as if some great bridge was unfolding over the air between us. He is 68 years old. He was born in the throat of Jim Crow, Alabama, one of 10 children. Their bodies side by side in the kitchen each morning, like a pair of hands exulting. Over breakfast, I ask him to tell me the hardest thing about going to school back then, expecting some history I have already memorized. Boycotts and attack dogs, fire hoses, Bull Connor in his personnel tank, candy paint shining white as a slaver's ghost. He says, having to read the Canterbury Tales. He says, eating lunch alone. Now I hear the word America and think first of my father's loneliness. The hands holding the pens that stabbed him as he walked through the hallway, unclenched palms settling onto a wooden desk, taking notes, trying to pretend ashamed and feeling an inheritance. You say democracy, and I see the men holding documents that sent him off to war a year later. Motown blaring from a country boy's bunker as napalm scarred the sky into jigsaw patterns. His eyes open wide as the blooming blue heart of the light bulb in a Crown Heights basement, where he and my mother will dance for the first time, their bodies swaying like rockets in the impossible dark. And yes, I know this is more than likely not what you mean when you sing liberty, but this is the only kind I know or can readily claim. The times where those hunted by history are underground and somehow daring to love what they cannot hold or fully fathom, when the stranger is not a threat but a promise of a different ending. I woke up this morning, and there were men on television lauding a wall big enough to box out an entire world. families torn with a stroke of pen, citizenship, little more than some garment that can be stolen or reduced to a cinder at a tyrant's whim. My father knows this, grew up knowing this, witnessed firsthand the firebombs, the clan, multiple messiahs' love, soaked and shot through. Somehow still believes in this grand blood-stained experiment, still votes, still prays that his children might make a life unlike any he has ever seen. He looks at me like the promise of another cosmos, and I never know what to tell him. All of the books in my head have made me cynical and distant, but there's a choir in him that calls me forward my disbelief, built as it is from the bricks of his belief. Not in any America you might see on network news or hear heralded from a football game, but in the quiet power of Sam Cooke's singing that he was born by a river that remains unnamed, that he runs alongside to this day, some vast and future country, some nation within a nation, black as candor. Loud is the sound of my father's unfettered laugh over cheese, eggs, and coffee. His eyes shut tight as armories, his fists were unclenched as if he were invincible.
Nova Scotia has over 50 historic African Nova Scotian communities with a long, deep, and complex history, beginning with a man named Matthew da Costa, who arrived in Nova Scotia with French explorers in 1605. He was the first ever black man recorded on Canadian soil. From there on, many black loyalists, migrants, maroons, and refugees would enter Nova Scotia from the south under the provision of the Act to Limit Slavery and the Act Against Slavery. In 1851, the Anti-Slavery Society of Canada was formed with the mission to promote global abolition of slavery and provide relief to African American refugees seeking freedom to Canada. Through the 1900s, Nova Scotia bore witness to the emergence of more black men, women, and organizations breaking through the barriers of society, such as Madeline Simmons, who was the first black woman to become a teacher in the province, and Isaac Fales of Sydney, Nova Scotia, who became the first black Canadian to be appointed to the Order of Canada. African Heritage Month provides us with the opportunity to look back and reflect on the history of the African Nova Scotian community and celebrate the culture, legacy, achievements, and contributions of this community. As black loyalists settled in Nova Scotia, a number of communities across the province were established. These communities were located on less desirable land near previously existing white settlements. These communities were intended to be far enough away that they were out of sight, but close enough so workers could travel. Our local history can be traced back to Tracadie in Antigonish County. Tracadie was one of the larger black loyalist communities that was not intended to be a smaller satellite community for the convenience of a larger white town. The land in Tracadie was 3,000 acres given to 74 black loyalists in 1787. The original settlement was home to many with last names you will recognize in our community today. Thank you. The African Canadian Heritage and Friendship Center is a vital resource for maintaining and sharing our local Black history. Located in the Guysborough Academy, the center has a collection of photographs, publications, and newspaper articles documenting the history of African Nova Scotians in and from the local area. The late Clarence Prince and his wife Joanne, former school board members, played a major role in securing the resources to build the African Canadian Heritage Friendship Center. The couple also designated the unique picture built into the floor that features an outline of the continent of Africa. The center runs many programs and invites speakers for students and teachers within Chetabucto Place, and is also an open resource center to other schools and educational institutes, as well as being open to the public. You are encouraged to plan a visit to the center once COVID restrictions are lifted.
The 2020-21 African Heritage Month provincial theme, Black History Matters, Listen, Learn, Share, and Act, recognizes the important legacy of people of African descent and the long-standing history in the development of Canada. This theme brings focus and increased awareness of racialized issues of a community that has overcome great adversity for inclusion of all aspects of society. It further calls on us to learn, listen, share, and act to make society a better place. The theme also aligns with the United Nations International Decade for People of African Descent, 2015 to 2024. The goal of the decade for people of African descent is to strengthen global cooperation in support of people of African descent, increase awareness, and the passage towards a presence in all aspects of society.
Hello everyone, I'm Owen McCarron, warden from the municipality of the County of Antigonish. I'm disappointed we're not able to get together this year to celebrate the launch of African Heritage Month. It's one of the events I look most forward to each year. The energy and pride felt during the celebration is truly remarkable. I hope that we can all get together this time next year. African Heritage Month provides an opportunity to promote knowledge and history while instilling respect and understanding. It is a time to recognize and salute the many contributions and ongoing achievements of people of African descent all over the world and right here in Antigonish County. This year's theme for African Heritage Month is Black History Matters. Listen, learn, share, and act. This past year has highlighted an incredible need for learning from our past and ensuring that our actions moving forward are different and to help support institutional and community change. The theme this year provides a roadmap for us to honor what is happening and make change. Recognize and respect history, listen to our community, and learn where change is needed. I encourage all residents, businesses, and community groups to participate in activities and celebrations and take the opportunity to reflect on the story of Nova Scotians, vibrant African Nova Scotian community. Thank you.
Hey everyone, it's Sean Fraser here, and I wanted to take just a minute of your time to reflect on the importance of celebrating Black History Month in our communities. I also want to say thank you to the town of Antigonish for taking on this important event to commemorate Black History Month locally. You know, for a lot of the wrong reasons, the importance of drawing attention to anti-Black racism has been at the front of mind of Canadians. Unfortunately, it took the senseless murder of George Floyd by a Minneapolis police officer to really appreciate the severity of what Black people are dealing with, not just in the United States, but in Canada here too. But watching the response to that tragedy in our own communities with people from different walks of life, different racial backgrounds, getting behind the Black Lives Matter movement to march in the streets in solidarity with our Black neighbors to celebrate the important contributions made by African Nova Scotians on over the course of our province's history has been nothing short of inspiring. You know, I think back to when I was a kid, and I think of Henderson Paris from Pictou County, who launched when I was a kid the Run Against Racism, now the Marathon of Respect and Equality. It's shameful to think back at the time, but when I was young, I thought that, that event was designed to commemorate the end of racism, a fight that had been had and won. And boy, was I wrong. When I think of the examples that come from our own province, from our own communities, it doesn't take long to realize that the experience of African Nova Scotians has been so much different than the life experience that I had growing up. I think about the tragedy in Africville. I think about the continued struggle for land titles across our province for African Nova Scotians. I think about just a couple hundred meters from where I'm sitting now is the Roseland Theater, where Viola Desmond was pulled out for daring to sit in a whites-only section of a movie theater. These are the kinds of things that seem unconscionable to us. And though many of these things happen in the history of our province, anti-Black racism continues to be a very real and very serious threat to everyone's well-being. We are all missing out because of the systemic discrimination in the justice system against African Nova Scotians. We are all missing out because Black entrepreneurs don't have access to the same networks, the same funding opportunities that others do. We are all missing out because we don't have the perspective of African Nova Scotians at leadership tables that so many people who look like I do have. There are injustices that exist throughout our system here in Nova Scotia and across Canada. And I think it's important that everyone reflect on these injustices and decide what they can do to help make a difference. Because when you bring different perspectives to the table, the discussions that are had are improved significantly. So to my friends and neighbors from the African Nova Scotian community, I want you to know that you have my commitment to use the platform that I have to continue to pursue racial equality, to call out anti-Black discrimination at every opportunity, and to work to advance the interest of African Nova Scotians here in our community and across Canada. Because at the end of the day, it's in the interest of everyone to pursue this sort of equality. Thank you again to the Town of Antigonish for organizing this important event. And I want to say to my African Nova Scotian friends and neighbors, this month is going to be important, and I want to be there shoulder to shoulder with you every step of the way.
Thank you to the organizers of today's virtual launch of African Heritage Month in Antigonish. Thank you for coming up with a format that allows our community to recognize African Heritage Month while following the COVID-19 restrictions set by Nova Scotia Public Health to keep everyone safe. I'm always honored to be offered the opportunity to participate in this proclamation event and to pay tribute to African History Month. This year's theme, Black History Matters, Listen, Learn, Share, and Act. In the last year, we've seen a social awakening. Black Lives Matter has touched the lives of communities and individuals across North America. Too late for many, yet inspiring and a springboard for positive change in society. History matters. Black history and Black lives matter. We must learn from history. We know we need to do better, and this year's theme makes that clear. Individually and as a society, we must listen, learn, share, and act. Listen to the stories and experiences, the good and the bad. Learn from those stories and experiences. Learn how to do better. Share them. Never forget where we came from. Remember those who have come before us and how they shaped our province's history, for better and worse, so that those who come after us can also learn from the mistakes of the past and be inspired by the courage and action of those who have made a positive impact. And we must act. Act to avoid the mistakes of the past and to do better. I want to acknowledge my colleague, Minister Tony Ince, for his friendship and his willingness to lead by example. I've listened and learned from stories he's shared, personal experiences that have shaped him and his commitment to spur action to make our province even better. Better by recognizing, celebrating, and supporting each other, rather than judging and tearing down. I remain in awe at the resilience of African Nova Scotians, and I encourage all residents of Antigonish and people across the province to take the time to listen and learn throughout the month, and commit to act. Be the action, large or small, commit to act in a way that will strengthen our understanding of our past and our commitment to do better today and into the future. Thank you again to everybody who organized today's event and the other events that are taking place throughout the month. Thank you for your contribution to African History Month, but also thank you to all those who listen, learn, share, and act throughout the year.
Hi, Antigonish. Happy African Heritage Month. I'm so glad that I was invited to be part of your celebration this year. My name is Abena Beloved Green, and I'm going to do a poem for you called Blazing Hope. Let's do it. Yes, we are dark, and we absorb light. Therefore, we're bright, we're bright, we're bright. Shout in the valley, sing as we fight, unveiling the night, the night, the night. Countless were they tilling the ground, and lost will be found, be found, be found. History lives poetically sound, and truth will abound, abound, abound. Take up your pens, ready your ink. Remember to watch, to hear, to think. Many were barred from gaining the skill, but sharp were they still, sharp were they still. Like sculptors and potters and painters of hues, this language we use, we use, we use. Stroking with eyes, splashing with hands, thoughts we command, command, command. Through proverbs and plays, prose and haikus, whichever you choose, you choose, you choose. Offer your stories, anchor your views, unwrap your blues, your blues, your blues. The veins to which blood pumps to our hearts resembles this art, this mesmeric art. Transmitting life on rivers of words, so sing the birds, so sing the birds. If the beautiful ones are not yet born, we call them to come, to come, to come. And if they are here gracing this earth, I seek to be one, be one. Though this life ain't been no crystal stair, they steadily climbed and climbed and climbed, sanding the rough and scraggly wood for those next in line, in line, in line. Learning from life when we've gone wrong, the journey is short, but the lesson is long. Some demonstrate and some speak it plain. We are not here in vain, in vain, in vain. Vast is our purpose, great are our gifts, and all people we lift, we lift, we lift. If ever you feel less than beloved, may paradise birds lift your chin. The edge of heaven draw you close. There is power within, within, within. Another country beckons your soul, and this earth, my brother, lends you proof that blended vessels we've become, showing Africadian roots. Echoes of anthems, archers of time, evincing the sun, we shine, courageous as Moses, adaptive as oak, borrowed beauty, blazing hope.
I'm Andy Haken, and I have the privilege of serving as the President and Vice Chancellor of St. Francis Xavier University. African Heritage Month is an important time for awareness, education, as well as a time to shine a spotlight on the culture and contributions of African Nova Scotians to our communities, something we should do throughout the year, not only this month. It's an important time to honour and celebrate the contributions that African Nova Scotians, both past and present, have made to our society. To recognise all those who have laid the foundation, to acknowledge their successes and struggles, and to honour their legacy by continuing to strive for equality in society. This past year, we saw a huge social movement in Black Lives Matter. More than ever, we need to work together with clarity and compassion for a better, more just tomorrow, where we celebrate all cultures in our community, where everyone is treated with equality, where everyone can thrive. While we have more to do at Centrefx, we have taken a number of steps forward to embrace and build diversity, including through the Diversity Education Centre on campus, a space dedicated to enhancing Centrefx's efforts to support traditionally underrepresented student populations on campus. With the Racial Justice Leadership Grants introduced at the McKenna Centre, with the LIFT Bursary established by a group of alumni to help the next generation attend Centrefx, and with the scholarship and awards such as the Janine DeVore Educational Equity Fund, specifically tailored to support African Nova Scotian students' access to post-secondary education. At Centrefx, we're proud of our students, faculty and staff who are achieving and working hard toward a better future where everyone feels that they belong and can be themselves. We need to lift all voices. This year's theme of Black History Matters, listen, learn, share, and act, encourages to do just that. We need to listen and we need to learn from what we've heard. And importantly, we need to share what we've learned and to act. We have the ability to create change if we all work together. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Paul Landry, Regional Executive Director with the Strait Regional Center for Education. I am pleased to join you today to bring greetings as you launch your African Heritage Month virtual proclamation and celebrations for 2021. February is recognized internationally as African Heritage Month, a time to honor the many contributions and ongoing achievements of people of African descent from all over the world. This year's African Heritage Month provincial theme, Black History Matters, Listen, Learn, Share, and Act, recognizes the important legacy of people of African descent and their long-standing history in the development of Canada. The theme also aligns with our Regional System Improvement Plan goal to foster student well-being through the creation of safe, positive, inclusive, and culturally responsive learning and work environments. Each February, our schools focus on the history, culture, and achievements of people of African descent. It is also very important that we extend these opportunities throughout the school year in an effort to further highlight the importance of African heritage and our shared history. This year's theme also aligns well with what we strive to promote in our classrooms each and every day. Opportunities to listen to one another, to learn about our shared history, to share and celebrate our cultures, and to act to make our communities a better place for all. I would like to acknowledge the work of our employees of African descent. The importance of having role models for our students cannot be overstated. And I am pleased our students of African descent see themselves reflected in the role models in our schools. I firmly believe education brings equality, and if we continue our collaboration and ongoing work with education partners, our efforts will bring many positive results and successes for our students. Thank you for the kind invitation to join your celebration.